I have a question from Joe Butte from Quantico. He said, how are you using additive manufacturing to close the gap with obsolete parts? And then kind of piggybacking on that, since we're talking about sort of forward-leaning technologies, there's another question about the impact of artificial intelligence and autonomy on the future supply chain. So two kind of future forward-leaning supply chain questions there.
Sure. Yeah, great questions and thanks for those. So on the additive manufacturing front, so we're engaged with each of the services. So all the military services are all on the additive manufacturing journey as we are and working to kind of keep pushing the frontier of what the technology enables in terms of additive manufacturing. From a DLA standpoint, so there's a couple key points that. So one is making sure from a technical specifications and intellectual property data rights perspective, if we as we identify components that we want to additively manufacture, we're working to figure out, hey, do we have the technical data and the things that we need to be able to go additively manufacture that. I keep talking about this widget that I want to get. So if I have a widget, it may not be the most cost effective. Additive manufacturing might not be the most cost-effective way to mass produce it. So I may still want to have traditional manufacturing for kind of the day-to-day peacetime, if you will, maintenance of the supply chain. But wouldn't it be great for a wartime requirement if I needed one of those, and if I needed even better, if one of the military services needed to be able to produce that widget forward on the battlefield, and they had the additive manufacturing capability that they could print a replacement widget. We want to have, wouldn't that be great from a readiness standpoint, be able to do that? And it might not be cost effective from a business standpoint, but it would be very readiness effective from a warfighting advantage perspective. And then I'll pivot over to the AI. That is something that we are really excited about and trying to keep pushing forward as we look to modernize our systems, as we look to modernize our technology, and to not just modernize, but to integrate our technology with the services, with industry, and across the logistics enterprise, being able to bring in machine learning and artificial intelligence capabilities is critical to if we're going to be able to move with agility and speed, in the future and in kind of the fight of the future. I mentioned before, that we've got about 5 million stock numbers, 5 million lines of items, individual items that we're responsible for. And so from a human standpoint, being able to just kind of wrap your head around that scale and those numbers is pretty daunting. So to be able to really get after that, we need to be able to figure out how to get those things where I can just kind of pawn those off to the machine and let the AI churn on those and run on those. And make sure that we're meeting the warfighter requirement for those items, and then neck down that universe to the kind of the true hard case supply chain challenge issues, if you will, that need the human touch, that need the human involvement, and we can bring kind of that higher level analytical thinking from a human standpoint to kind of work those supply chain issues. So we're working with OSD's advanced analytics. Avana is a platform to bring data fusion together and kind of pull data in a way that enables users across the enterprise to apply these AI type tools and to have a common sight picture and common visibility. So we're leaning forward heavily on that and working that with the services and with the combatant command so that when we all look at the supply chain. Do we have a common sight picture? And do we have a consistency of data to then be able to apply these advanced tools?